Hello everyone, my name is Maulik Domadia and I am a final year student at Gandhinagar Institute of Technology.
And I am Tejas Khanna and I am also a final year student at Gandhinagar Institute of Technology. Today we will try to share our final year project that is called Hair Miner with you, and we hope you will enjoy this. Every good product starts with a good problem. In our case also, the problem was simple: indoor air pollution. How do we tackle it? Wow. One thing that we could have done is to build air purifiers, but we did not do that. Our aim was to let the users of our product know when the ppm levels of carbon monoxide and odorless, colorless, tasteless gas would go higher in their house. This graph explains this very simply. When the ppm levels increase, the danger level increases. The danger level means danger to your health, and so on and so forth. So what is our solution to this? How do we let the users know that the ppm levels are rising in their house? Well, first we need a detector. We need a carbon monoxide detector, since that's the only gas that we are interested in right now. Then we need a history of all the times when the ppm levels were high. As a simple example, if somebody burns something near your house at 6 pm every day, you would know that gases are coming inside your house at that time. That's how we are going to figure out the trend of the ppm rise and dip inside the house. The schematic or the final system for this is very simple. You have a board, a microcontroller board, and that board is used with the MQ7 CO sensor. From that board, we use the Wi-Fi module to send the PPM values to Google Sheets using an API. Inside the Google Sheets, there is a trend function. As I just explained, a trend will give you approximate predictions based on past history values. That trend is now sent to the website, Air Miner's website that we had built. We had tested it on localhost. Now, this prediction is displayed on the front end of the website like so, as a bar graph or as any other form of visual representation. That solves the problem. Now, a user can know beforehand that maybe tomorrow at 6 a.m. or 6 p.m., COPPM might dip or might rise. So now that you know that the CO level might rise at 6 p.m., you can explore the cause of this CO leakage or this cause of the increase in rise of concentration of CO. Maybe somebody near your house is burning something, or maybe... So you will have awareness about the COPPM levels, and that's what we wanted to do.
Start.
Now let's see the circuit. So first, every circuit needs a power source. So this is a 9-volt battery, as you can see. Now this thing that you see here is an integrated circuit, or IC 7805. The reason for this is that our circuit only works on 5 volt, and we did not have a 5 volt supply. So what this basically is doing is this 9 volt is going in and 5 volt is coming out as an output. Now we have used this transistor here. This, as you see, is a transistor. Now we are using this transistor as a switch inside this circuit, and if you observe this gas sensor, it has in here, it has 4 pins. One of those pins is called the analog output pin, then the digital output pin, VCC and ground pin. So we have configured this circuit in such a way that 2 pins from here are directly connected to the VCC pin of this circuit. And the reason for that is that that was the only way that the circuit could work. Finally, in the VCC, in the analog output pin, is directly connected to the analog output pin of this ESP8266 board. And finally, from this point, we have programmed the board to send this A0 to a web server using the Wi-Fi module, which is right here. This is the Wi-Fi module. Now we shall see what happens on the side of the web server and the output on.
From NodeMCU, the data has been sent to the Google Sheet, as you can see. Now what end user have to do is export as CSV format. We have already done that part and store here. Now we have to drag and drop into our website. As we will drag and drop the data file, here it will be the data frame, which is of NodeMCU, and over here you can see graph, that is the visualization for the next day.
Now let's see the application. So the first application that was pretty obvious to all of us was that if you want to know whether you need air purifiers or not, you can check the concentration of ppm, concentration levels of carbon monoxide. Secondly, it is all about spreading awareness about what might be the possible reasons for pollution near your house, in your apartment, in your building, in your society, etc. Finally, polluted places like New Delhi, there indoor air pollution and air pollution itself is a very big issue. So what we can do is that by building such systems, we can help people know and be aware of the kind of pollution happening in their cities. So I hope you enjoyed this session, and keep innovating, keep creating, and stay curious. I am Tejas Khanna, and I hope you enjoyed this. And
hi, Maulik Dumaria.